morning going to the pastoral handshake. You know you're preaching today. Well, preachers always preach. I just want to say that the years that I've had with the church here have been wonderful years. They began actually in 1980 when I was pastor of the Gibbon Baptist Church and Maurice Simpson was my youth leader. It's true. Anyhow, Maurice brought property out here in Whoopi Street and so had three or four other families from Gibbon, and these were to form part of the original church fellowship, we called it then, which became constituted as a church. But my association, I have to say, with Maurice goes back before he was born. So, yeah, you work that out. I was in the RAAF in Cairns, and his mum and dad were very hospitable people. Ned was the choir leader, and he roped a few of us in to sing in the choir. And I think it's in a visitor's book, the record of the visit of some of us on the 23rd of December, 1943. Now, Maurice was only a twinkle in his dad's eye then. Actually, he wasn't born until 1944 in September. But they were wonderful people, and they taught us how to have a siesta. You know what a siesta is in South America, you would. But they made sure that we got a cushion and lay on the lino floor for about an hour after lunch. So that was something I learned from Maurice's family. But that association blossomed when we came to Gibbon and he was the youth leader there. And then this church embryo was in the making. At the time, I was probably the old man out amongst the pastors round about. They didn't want a church here, but because they were scared they were going to lose members to Bracekenridge Church. Well, it did actually happen, but I really saw the potential from the day I saw the sign outside, a church is proposed on this site. And the wise people from Nanda had built the land and put a sign up. That was their hope. And we saw it realised in the years that followed. Now, I've got to watch that I don't start preaching, but I want to say it was a wonderful experience to be associated with the beginning of a church. And we have some lovely friends from our church who were here, and they came along with numbers of others. Some of them not connected ever with Baptist churches before, and this formed the Bracekenridge Fellowship, which ultimately became Bracekenridge Baptist Church. And I was very happy to see that happen and to be part of it, because we were foundation members. Now, I think I've probably exhausted most of what I had to say, but I have a poem I'd like to read. Is it there? Yeah. No? Oh, well, I can't do it. Christmas time, 2006. Oh, yes. Sweetman. Ah, yes. Here it is. Then you
wish. Hey, well done.
Thank God for the mingles. We love our mingles outings because they are such fun. Thanks to our great leader who keeps us on the run. She plans her many bus trips, heading north and south and west, occasionally returning to places we all like best. We like to see Toowoomba when the flowers are at their prime. We travel with cross-country tours to ensure that we're there on time. Our eyes feast on the colour in gardens, homes and parks. Then we motor down the toll bar, singing like the larks. Sometimes we drive to Shawncliffe. There's a view across the bay. You can walk out on the pier and enjoy a lovely day. Fish and chips are on the menu, or maybe a catered meal. Whatever form or shape it takes, we're assured it's a good deal. Another favourite spot of ours is that place upon the lake that once was used by Wunnakees, their well-earned rest to take. If you take the time to listen, you may hear the whiplash crack or hear the teamsters shouting at their bullocks on the track. I was careful not to say what they had. The latest trip we did take was to the Glasshouse Mountain. We all enjoyed our morning tea at the foot of Tibagaga. And then I urged to climb those hills rose in us like a fountain, but a certain trembling in our legs turned our back upon that mountain. We headed off to Strawberry Fields, for that was our intention, to feast upon those sweet delights and never wait to venture. But our driver had another plan. Ere we reached our destination, he took us up past Crookneck to view Mount Beulah with Ignatian. Today we meet to share a treat we call it Christmas luncheon. We all know it's more than that, a very special function. Today we're here to celebrate and honour Christ our Lord as we enjoy sweet fellowship around this festive day. If you've been out with the Minglers throughout the year that's passed, I'm sure you will agree with me that good times never last. Yet the good outweighs the bad times and cancels out our strife. We thank God for the Minglers, for they brighten up our lives.
Prayer, I'd just like to share just a tiny bit of Psalm 24 with you. I know it's a special psalm. The Lord, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not lift up his soul to what is false, and does not swear deceitfully. He will receive blessing from the Lord, and vindication from the God of his salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek the face of God of Jacob. And that's everyone. God bless you.
And thank you.
But my grandmother raised me, my grandparents raised me, and she taught me scriptures, and two of the scriptures was John 14, the whole chapter, and the other one was the psalm you just read.
And I did cheat because I read his memoirs.
I want to thank all those who made a special effort to come here today. And I want to say I am that Richard acknowledged Dorothy's ministry. The other day at the home, two of the nurses were bringing her into the dining room for breakfast. What do you think she was singing? Stand up for Jesus, you soldiers of the cross. I cried really because one of the girls said, we said to her, now stand up, and that was an order. And then she added, because she was a Christian girl, stand up for Jesus. And Dorothy taught them the first verse.